chattering like a fish. Do you have gin?
Of course. You mean straight gin?
No, gin and soda, I guess.
Gin and soda?
Well, it's wrong, isn't it? It's scotch and soda. How do you drink gin?
Well, there's gin and tonic, except I don't have any tonic. Then there's gin and vermouth. That's a martini.
That sounds cool. I think I'll have a glass of that. A big, tall one.
Big, tall martini.
This is a much nicer apartment than the Kaufman. For instance, the Kaufman's have no stairs. Hey, where did they lead to?
No place.
No place? A stairway to nowhere. I think it's just elegant.
Oh, I wouldn't say elegant. You see, this used to be a duplex, this place in the Kaufman. So when the landlord made two apartments out of it, he just boarded up the ceiling, or in your case, the floor.
Oh, yes. I remember that square patch in the floor. The first day I dropped my cuticle pusher down the crack.
Cuticle pusher? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, here you are. Big, tall martini.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Very good. Maybe it needs a little more sugar.
Sugar? No, I would strongly advise against putting sugar in a martini.
You would? Why?
Well, you just have to take my word for it. No sugar in a martini, ever.
That's funny. Back home, they put sugar in martinis a lot.
Back home? Where?
In Denver, Colorado. Oh. Hey, you've got air conditioning. How does it work? Put it on.
Sure. I got air conditioning in every room. Isn't the Kaufman place air conditioned?
Gee, no. It's just terrible up there. That's why I bought the electric fan. This feels just elegant. I'm just not made for the heat. This is my first summer in New York, and it's practically killing me. You know what I tried yesterday? I tried to sleep in the bathtub. Just lying there, up to my neck in cold water.
That sounds like a good idea.
But there was something wrong with the faucet. It kept dripping. It was keeping me awake. So you know what I did? I pushed my big toe up the faucet.
I guess that's what they call American know-how.
The only thing was, my toe got stuck and I couldn't get it back out again.
You couldn't?
No, but thank goodness there was a phone in the bathroom, so I was able to call the plumber.
You called the plumber?
Oh, sure. He was very nice. Even though it was Sunday, I explained the situation to him, and he rushed right over.
Did everything come out all right?
Oh, sure. But it was sort of embarrassing.
Yeah, I could see how it might have been.
Honestly, I almost died. There I was with a perfectly strange plumber, and no polish on my toenails.